Hello everyone, Suzanne here. Just wanted to show you how I go about making a shaker card and the 3D cake that I put in my explosion box for my first design team project for Arnie Vera Scrap and Craft. So, for the shaker card, I've got this Sizzix die. I cut it out 8 times with pink cardstock and I layer 6 of them together like so. With the other two, in between them I layer a piece of acetate, and to glue the acetate in I always use glossy accents. So you have to be really, really careful and not put it too close to the edge. So I use my circle dies. Spellbinders circle dies to cut out a circle that is like as round as to where the scallop begins, and I try and keep the glossy accents out here. You can see I've got a bit here, it's a bit smoky, but I'll be able to clean that up. So I put that between two of the die cuts. And you have to let these bits dry before you can add any shaker elements. So for the back of this one, because I'm going to put this one in my daughter's explosion box, I'm going to put hugs and kisses on the back. So for the one I made for the design team project, I used this tape and I just layered it across until it was wholly covered in the tape. But I'm going to put hugs and kisses on the inside of this one. Going to use too much glue because I want to do this pretty quickly. I want to try and get it in the middle as best I can. Okay, and that's going to go on the back of there. Okay, so just want to add glue around the edge, not inside, otherwise all the elements are going to stick to it. Okay, so like that. I will stick a pink one over that when I'm done, but I'm just going to pretend that's dry and I'm going to add a few things. So that feels like it's stuck together, so I'm going to add a few pink sequins. Make sure they're up the right way. That's enough of them. And I've got some tiny little Oh, the cork's just breaking up in my hands. Okay, I'm gonna have to dig that out. Excuse me a minute. Oh, now it's gone in the bottle. Awesome. All right, I add a few of those. Whatever that is. Cork, I suppose. Okay, so that's dark pink. I got some light pink ones. I've got some little pink, bright pink hearts. Put them in. And got some little pink hexagonal shaped glittery stuff. And I might leave it at that, I think. Now, because I've marked on here the top, because all of these are not shaped the same, so oops. So that one up the top there, this one is going to be where this mark has to go. They've got to be able to match up, because they're not all the same shape I discovered when I made the first one. So I just have to now glue the top on. It's quite a simple process once you get the gist of it. So that has got to go up there to match up. Now you've got to leave it flat while it dries, because you don't want it sticking to the sides. Okay, so that's that. I'll put that to the side to dry. Now just wanted to show you what I did to make the 3D cake. So this was in the Make It Spellbinders die, and with it I made this cake. Okay. So what I did was I cut this die, the cake stand die, 9 times with white cardstock, and then 3 times with some of the pattern paper. I layered up 3 in each one. There are 3 white cardstock and then 1 of the coloured paper. You can't really see that very well because I've used the grey bluey tones. Then for the 3 cake layers, I didn't use this die, but I measured about how high it was going to be, and I used a 1/2 inch strip for this one, 3/8 of an inch for this one, and yeah, I think that's what it was, and maybe just 2/8 for that one. I used my circle dies, so I used 2 from here and 1 from here to get the 3 sizes. And then I just made circles until it fit the, so I cut strips and, you know, made a circle until it fit that top. Okay. And then all you have to do is glue those together. That's pretty simple. For the cake plate, to keep in style with the scallop on here, I've made a scallop plate. So to make the bottom, to make this part here, we have to bend these in the center, and it's not an easy task because it's quite thin. So I kind of just ran my nail down it a few times and did a few things to try and bend it in the, hopefully the right place, so that I could join three of them together. So I might just try and do it with my nails, I think. So just trying to get it close to the middle if you can. Bend it backwards so that you're going to be able to join the three of them together. Now for this one, I did use my very precious dries clear glitter glue. Oh gosh, what a mess. And I just put some of this on, just one side at a time. Spread it around and get these, get two joined up for a start. So if you can get the bottom and the top joined and just hold them together for a bit. I hope I'm in frame. So I just held them together and then try and squish these ones out so I can fit this one in here. Hope this works. In here the best you can. Oops. Okay. So that's not too bad. So good. No, that's not too bad, I don't think. Get them joined up. Them. Okay. Okay. And there you have it. Now, this is going to go on top. I did the same with the little topper. Cut it three times, fold it down the middle. Together. same as last time though. You want to get three together. That. How you make a 3D cake. Of course, you glue it all together so that it stays together, and that's pretty much it. I hope you have a go at that. It's great fun. I've also done a 3D bird cage. If you look back at some of my videos, you see I've done a bird cage the same kind of way. Thanks for watching. Bye.